This next fella is a magician. He's so clever, he's actually disappeared from the show he's meant to be at right now to join us. So can you please make welcome from the Fringe hit show, Deception, the wonderful Matt Tarrant.
Thank you so much. Paul, we're going to play a game, and I might actually ask for your help if possible. Paul, big round of applause, please. Paul, we're going to play a game. It's called Russian Roulette. Have you played it before?
Only with a gun, Matt.
This is similar. This is my version. So I've got four bags, okay? Now, in three of those bags is a piece of wood. Pretty safe. In the last bag, though, we actually have another piece of wood with a metal spike attached.
Okay.
A metal spike. Put your hand out for me.
Okay.
Other way. Feels pretty real, yeah?
That's definitely a nail.
Yeah.
I'm not good with nails, though. No, in a previous life, I was nailed to a cross, and many of the holes in my feet haven't healed. Still find it difficult to walk across a pond.
I'm not going to get you to turn away.
You know I had a bad experience with a magician once.
I know. We're going to make... Hopefully this one works okay, because it could be the end of both of our careers. I'm going to move the bags around. So right now, you have no idea where the spike is, yeah?
Well, I'm watching the television over there. It's giving me a... Okay, that's better. Yeah, that's better. That's good.
Turn back around.
Okay.
Because the thing is, I know where the spike is, as do every single person at home and watching right now. What I'd like you to do, when you're happy, move the bags around yourself. So just lift them up, move them around. Now, with the other pieces of wood, you won't feel any weight differences or anything, so there should be no way for you to know which bag contains the spike.
Okay.
It kind of looks like I'm flashing you, but when I sort of am...
Okay, good.
And let me know when you're happy.
I'll take too long. Okay,
you're done. Okay, so you're 100% happy. Right now, you don't know where the spike is, and I don't know where the spike is.
I have never been 100% happy, but I'm as happy as I'm going to be.
I'm going to place this on. Now, if you like, if you think I've sort of peaked or something, you can also move them around once more if you really want to. If you're happy, though, place your hand in my hand.
In your hand?
Yeah. So just
on your hand?
Yeah. Under. There, perfect.
Good, lovely.
This feels quite nice, Paul.
I know, I'm enjoying it. It's like a blind date for you, but I'm having a good time.
What I'd like you to do is to place your hand over a bag where you don't think contains the spike.
A bag I don't think contains the spike?
Correct.
Okay. Is it the one you're pushing my hand
whatever
towards?
Whatever one you want.
Okay. Let's go this way. No. Okay.
We're over a bag?
Hey? Yeah, we're over a bag.
And you're 100% sure there's no spike in this bag?
I'm not 100% sure. Of course I'm not 100% sure. You're a magician. Really. I'm 100% sure. No, I'm not.
Okay.
Put it up! Oh, you mother!
Good choice. There's now three bags left. What I'd like you to do is to have a feel and work out, just going over, which one feels good. I don't want to push you towards any.
Oh, no, don't push me. This one feels best. Okay, Matt. I don't know. Good.
No. You're over a bag?
Yeah.
And you're 100% happy there's no spike in this bag?
Yeah, there's no spike.
That also felt quite good. That felt quite good, Paul. The thing is, there's two left. 50-50.
Yeah.
This is when most magicians make the biggest mistake of their careers. Put your hand over the first bag that's left.
Yes.
Is the spike in that bag?
I have no idea.
Second one? Where's the second one?
Here's the second one, yeah.
Is the spike in that bag?
No, this one. This one's the one. It's not good.
That's the one?
Yeah.
You sure?
No, of course I'm not sure.
Tonight you made three decisions, three choices. Luckily for you, that last bag contains
it. Oh my God.